Hyperlink's VX2.8 includes support for DDR5 and LPDDR5 memory technology, including IBIS-AMI models. Two different simulation modes are supported: interactive simulation for quick what-if analysis, and batch-level simulation for full pre- and post-layout interface-level verification. Let's start with an interactive simulation. We'll take a DDR5 memory bus that was originally designed to run at 3200 megabit, and we'll push it to 4800 megabit just to see what happens. We can see that we have three different simulation modes with IBIS-AMI models. Statistical simulation gives us very quick simulation results. Time domain or bit-by-bit simulation allows us to model the effect with specific patterns, and the advanced DDRcx AMI algorithm allows us to deal with rising and falling edge asymmetry inherent in DDR technology. We can specify the parameters that we want to use for the transmit-receive equalization, and in this particular simulation, we'll take the number of DFE taps in the receiver and sweep it to see the effect of different levels of DFE on the eye at the receiver input. Once we run the simulation, we'll see the eye diagrams resulting, and we can see that differing the number of DFE taps has a dramatic effect on signal quality at the receiver input. Here's the signal with no DFE taps, here's the signal with two DFE taps, and here's the signal with four DFE taps in the receiver. Here we see a batch analysis of a full DDR5 pre-route interface, including strobe, data, data mask, clock, and address signals. We'll invoke the wizard and go through the setup pages that we normally see associated with the DDRcx wizard, defining the controller and the DRAM and all the different aspects of simulation. The new thing that we have in DDR5 is the presence of AMI models and transmit-receive equalization settings, which we can specify in the wizard and then sweep if we want to perform different what-if analysis. Once we start the simulation, and in this particular case, we've sped up the video so that the analysis is occurring a bit faster than normal. And with DDR5 models, now we see a full level interface report, including data read, data write, address, differential net, SKU, and eye density links, as with any other DDR technology. Here we see eye plots for data mask, data read, and data write operations. So Hyperlink now supports DDR5. Check it out.